Thanks for staying with us. You're still watching Plus TV Africa Election Studios. Well, let's move on to other matters. The new legal challenges emerging from the internet as social networks make it possible for false information to be published for political purposes, as well as new level of anonymous hate speech online. Now, these challenges are amplified by the international connectivity of social media users. So how do you identify fake news? This is where Bayo Olukponda, editor-in-chief of Legit.com, comes in. And of course, Taiwo Kola Ogunlade, communications and PR manager, Google West Africa. It's good to have you, gentlemen. It's good to have you back. You were on a few minutes ago.
We'll just get right on. He was with us a couple of seconds ago, so we'll just go straight to you, Bayo, with a question. Let's start with a definition. What makes fake news, and what would you regard as hate speech?
So two broad concepts, but can achieve the same end if deployed in election, because I know we're talking about elections.
Yes, in elections.
Fake news is actually a type of news that is fabricated, but presented as being factually accurate, okay? But yes, so we have different types of fake news. We have parody and satire. Of course, you must have seen on Twitter where you have some parody accounts. If you're not careful, you can think they are the real accounts. They are misleading news that are not based on facts. There are also some kind of news that are not based, that are contextually they are wrong. And then you have news that are intentionally meant to deceive. Okay, you have sloppy driven propaganda news. These are type of fake news that we have, really. And what is the other one?
Hate speech.
According to there's a human rights, European Council of Human Rights describes it as those type of speeches that are targeted, that they play on stereotypes, and they are targeted at groups. It can be people with disability, it can be your race, it can be your group. If you remember, during the Rwanda genocide, hate speech actually spurred on
the Hutu
to kill the Tutsis. People, when you refer to people as cockroaches, and you